The third interstellar visitor to trespass into our solar system, 3I Atlas, is exhibiting bizarre new behaviors that are shocking scientists. This is unlike anything we've ever seen. This isn't just another rock from another star. This is a riddle from the depths of space that's rewriting the rules and could fundamentally shake our understanding of the universe. Thought Oumuamua was weird? Thought Borisov was interesting? Buckle up, because 3I Atlas is a total game changer. In this video, we'll uncover the latest secrets of this cosmic outlaw and see how humanity is planning to chase it down. It all began on July 1st, 2025. The Atlas telescope detected a faint, ordinary-looking smudge in the sky. But this smudge was moving. And when its trajectory was calculated, all the alarms started ringing in astronomers' offices. The trajectory was hyperbolic. Mathematically, that meant it wasn't from our solar system, and it was never coming back. It was a cosmic bullet. But that wasn't the main anomaly. When archival data was scanned, a shocking truth was revealed. 3I Atlas had already woken up back in May 2025, when it was still beyond Jupiter's orbit, nearly a billion kilometers from the Sun. Our comets are like snowmen in a deep freeze, sleeping until the sun's warmth tickles them awake. But this visitor was wide awake in the pitch black, freezing cold. This was the first sign that something completely different, something far more volatile, was burning inside. What was it? The answer came from humanity's most powerful eye, the James Webb Space Telescope. Webb locked onto 3I Atlas and analyzed its atmosphere, its coma. The results were mind-blowing. This comet's breath wasn't made of water, but of carbon dioxide? That's right, the stuff we know as dry ice. The ratios were even more shocking. For every 8 molecules of carbon dioxide, there was only 1 molecule of water. This is one of the highest CO2 ratios ever seen in a comet. This discovery explained why it became active so far away. Carbon dioxide ice sublimates at much lower temperatures than water ice. 3I Atlas isn't a water-based entity, it's practically a frozen carbon dioxide bomb. This raises a massive question. What kind of heaven or hell was this thing born in? Was its home star system so different from ours that carbon dioxide, not water, was king? This could be the first living proof of just how exotic other planetary systems in the galaxy can be. And this is where the theory gets even crazier. Some scientists suggest that this strange chemical signature might not just point to a different star system, but to a different time. According to one model, 3I Atlas could have come from the Milky Way's thick disk, a region containing ancient stars from our galaxy's infancy, billions of years ago. Think about that for a moment. If this is true, 3I Atlas could have formed before our Sun and Earth were even a cloud of dust. It is, quite literally, a frozen time capsule from the birth of the galaxy. Inside, it carries the chemical secrets of the early universe. This isn't just a piece of another world. It's a ghost from another age. So how much time do we have to study this priceless messenger? Very little. 3I Atlas isn't a tourist. It's like a semi-truck speeding down the highway. It will pass by Mars in October 2025. On October 29th, it will reach its closest point to the Sun. Then, in March 2026, it will give a final nod to Jupiter and head back into the darkness from whence it came. Forever. That's why a global scientific mobilization has been declared. Every telescope, every radar, every satellite is pointed at it. Every single photon, every piece of data is worth its weight in gold. Because once it's gone, this chance will never come again. Right now, there are even discussions about whether the Juno spacecraft, currently orbiting Jupiter, could snap one last close-up photo as it flies by in March 2026. It might be the longest distance and most desperate paparazzi attempt in history. This missed opportunity has taught the scientific world a lesson. We can't just wait and watch, we have to act. This is where bold projects like the Interstellar Comet Explorer come into play. The idea is this: be ready for the next visitor. We need a high-speed, fully fueled interceptor spacecraft waiting in a cosmic parking spot like the L2 point. The moment a new interstellar object is detected, we ignite the engines and give chase. This isn't a science fiction movie. This is entirely possible with today's technology. ESA's Comet Interceptor mission works on the same principle. We will no longer wait for the target to come to us. We will go to the target. The next time a three-eye atlas appears, we'll greet it not just with telescopes, but with a robotic ambassador of our own. We will measure its dust, smell its gas, and for the first time, touch matter from another star. 3i Atlas is so much more than a fleeting flash of light in the sky. It's like a knock at our door. It's a reminder that we are not alone in the universe, and that the galaxy is a far more diverse, far stranger, and far more wonderful place than we ever imagined. Its carbon dioxide-rich nature forces us to ask, was the water necessary for life delivered to planets the way we thought? Perhaps water-rich systems are rare in the galaxy, and carbon dioxide-dominated systems are the norm. 3i Atlas will soon fade from view, but its legacy will be permanent. Thanks to massive new telescopes like the Vera Rubin Observatory, we expect to be detecting several of these visitors every year. This isn't an exception. It's the beginning of a new normal. The age of interstellar exploration has begun, and 3i Atlas was the first key that unlocked the door for us. When the next visitor arrives, we will be ready.